guys, and welcome back to my channel. Today I want to share with you guys 5 ways that I've saved time each and every week. If you follow my channel, you know that right now I am in a very busy season. I am working my day job, I am going to rehearsals, I am doing press for my show, and I'm running my YouTube channel on top of like social life, family, friends, boyfriend, what have you. So right now, any way that I could save time and utilize that 24 hours in a day, I will do it. So, any further ado, here are the top 5 things I do each and every week to save me the most time. This one might sound a little bit OCD, but number one, I like to lay out all my clothes for the work week. So I will put my, you know, outfit for Monday to the left, and then outfit for Tuesday, Wednesday, all the way through Friday. That way when I wake up in the morning, there is no what am I wearing today. It was decided on Sunday evening in my closet. I just pull it, put it on, and go. I know that sounds really anal retentive and just super like OCD, but I promise you, just having it laid out, don't even give yourself the option. You wake up, go to your bathroom, do what you need to do, put on the clothes, and you go on your way. Number two might also not be for everybody, but I wash my hair 1 time a week. That does not mean to say I do not shower every day and rinse at least my body off, but I try to only wash my hair 1 time a week. And I do have a schedule for ways to do my hair, like if it's already been clean for like 1 or 2 days, I'll wear it down, then I'll do like a side braid or an updo, just whatever I can do so I'm only washing it 1 night a week. And I do have dry shampoo, it gets me through everything. If you don't know what dry shampoo is, look that stuff up. You spray it around your crown, let it sit for a minute and rub it into your hair. It absorbs majority of the oil and makes it look like you just took a shower recently, and it smells awesome. So washing your hair 1 time a week will definitely save you time. And side note, it's actually good for your hair to let it sit in its natural oils, not strip it as much when you shampoo. Side note over. The third thing I do is I meal prep all my lunches on Sunday night. I have these little containers. They're actually linked down below in the description box if you look under things that I love. But every Sunday, I'll make a big batch of something with like 2 different sides and snacks, and I will put them in the little bento boxes. I have 5 of them. Put the lids on them, put them in the fridge, and then on Monday morning, I take an extra bag with me to work, and they go right into my office refrigerator. This also saves me the most money if I really think about it, because I work right in downtown Columbus and there are restaurants everywhere and they are very tempting to want to go to when you've had a stressful morning. But I know for me, it's right there. I can pull it out. It saves me the driving time and the money to go buy anything, and it just helps keep me sane and it helps keep my calories in check if I don't have time to go to the gym, which I haven't in a while. I literally am getting by with like walking 10,000 steps a day around my office and the park outside. Number 4 is I keep my work bag, shoes, whatever I need to take with me right by the door of my home. I have a little like entryway table, and I have these little prongs on the wall, and they hold my keys, my sunglasses, and on the table is my purse. On the floor are my shoes. So there's no running around in the morning. Where are my things? It's actually a really, really big pet peeve of mine. If I can't find what I need to leave the house in about 10 seconds, I'm going to get upset and wonder why I didn't set them out the night before. But again, it saves you so much time just to keep a flow in the morning. There's a pattern here to have a flow. I had my clothes laid out, my meals are already prepped, my stuff's by the door. Whatever I can do to make the day start smooth, it'll help me finish the day and stay just as calm. I can't control the things that happen during the day. They might not go as smooth then, but I can at least ensure it started off on a nice, smooth, and prepared schedule. And number 5 is something I've talked about in previous videos, and that is no social media for the first and last hour of each day. I cannot tell you how much time this saves. And side note, I have had Facebook off of my cell phone for over a month now. I have not had it on my phone, haven't put it back on there at all. If I want to check my Facebook or see what's going on, I have to be at a computer, which means I have to either like get up, get out of bed, go to the office, wherever I will be checking it, but I do not have it on my phone. There was just one day I woke up and I just said, this isn't helping me. I am not getting the things I need done on schedule by looking at this app. This is not helping me, it is hindering me, I'm getting rid of it. I still have Facebook chat on my phone because some of my friends from cruise ships live in other countries and the time zone difference makes it kind of a hassle, and they don't have the US cell phone system so they can't text me. And I do have the Pages app because I do run a Kristen Marie Facebook page. So I do have those, but as for like the actual Facebook app itself, I nicked it a long time ago, and I cannot tell you how much easier it is to fall asleep when you don't have your phone with you up until you turn the lights off, and how much easier your mornings are when you start them without social media. I do sometimes keep my phone with me in the morning if it's gonna play like my Google Play Music, but other than that, I try to keep off my phone and my social media for the first and last hour of the day. But anyway, those are the top 5 ways I like to save time each and every week. If you have any ways that you yourself like to utilize the 24 hours in your day, leave me a comment down below. I am very interested in seeing what you guys do, especially those that have kids. Extra props to you guys. If you like these kind of videos, let me know by giving this one a thumbs up. And if you are new to this channel, click that little red subscription button down below. It'll update you each and every time I upload a video. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.